الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. أحبتي وأحبائي في الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Again and again, if we keep talking about Laylatul Qadr till next year, till Ramadan, it will not be enough, wallahi, to talk about that wonderful and a great night as a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe one or two things, inshallah, I would like to share with you. And also to emphasize, in order when you receive that gift from Allah, Laylatul Qadr, to recognize that gift, to celebrate this gift, to value this gift, and to benefit from that gift as any gift you would receive from a dear person to you. The first ayah of Surah Al-Qadr, Inna Anzalnahu Fi Laylatul Qadr. Definitely, certainly, without any doubt, we brought down this Quran to you, Muhammad, waiting for you in Laylatul Qadr. In Laylatul Qadr. Allah kept it there. In the highest level ever. Waiting for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be brought down as the whole Quran to the lowest level of the heaven, waiting for Jibreel alayhi salam to bring it to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in 23 years, 13 years in Mecca and 10 years in Medina, as we all know, as it is known as Al-Wahy. Tayyib, the gift came to us. And we have the gift in our hands. And we recite that gift once in a while. Here is what I would love for you to leave with you till next year, inshallah, when we witness and when we celebrate and when we recognize again Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend our life and witness again Laylatul Qadr. Could be tonight or could be the 29th, inshallah, Rabbil Alamin. With the first ayah, Inna Anzalnahu Fi Laylatul Qadr, the Quran is in our hands. How you benefit from that gift? Here is what I would like for you for the rest of the year, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, to enjoy that gift in one ayah of the Quran. One ayah. If you would like to add, that's fine. Two ayat, three ayat, four ayat. Whatever, but one ayah I would like to emphasize tonight in order to stay with you, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, for the rest of the year. Surah Al-Fatiha, the opening of the book. And we read the first ayah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Second ayah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. What does it mean, Alhamdulillah? The translation, more or less. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning, I'm thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala no matter what happened to me in life. When I say ashukru lillah, being thankful and grateful to Allah for whatever He has given to me. And He give me something, I say, thank you. You help me with something, thank you. Allah is giving me something, thank you. But if you're giving me something as a human being like you and I want to appreciate it, I cannot come to you and say, Alhamdulillah, praise be to you. No. Alhamdulillah. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To no other deity, no other human being. Alhamdulillah. Why? Because we praise Allah for anything happening to us, good or bad. Good things, oh, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, that's great. Yeah, I got a house. Alhamdulillah, my business is going so well. Alhamdulillah, I graduated. Alhamdulillah, I'm making money. But how about if you lost your job?
الحمد لله. Get an action. والله الحمد لله. But we do not see it. We do not say it with the deep meaning of it. No matter happening to me, Alhamdulillah. Being good, Alhamdulillah. Being sick, Alhamdulillah. Making a lot of money, Alhamdulillah. Not making a lot, Alhamdulillah. I'm fine. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter what. If I'm not making enough money, I will do my best with Alhamdulillah to work as hard as I can to make the money I wanted to make. But Alhamdulillah, sincerely, coming from the depth of your heart, believing in it, no matter what, now I got the Quran, the gift from Allah, إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر. I understand it, I comprehend it, I apply it in my life, and for the rest of my life, Alhamdulillah. Can we make a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this Ramadan till next Ramadan, from this Laylatul Qadr to next Laylatul Qadr? When you read Surah Al-Fatiha, stop for a while in that only one verse of the Quran in Surah Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. But say it with that deep meaning of it. And I'm not asking you to know the whole meaning of Surah Al-Fatiha. If you do, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. If you don't, stick with that, Alhamdulillah. Especially when you have the difficult time, the test from Allah. I am losing something. And someone would ask me, when I say it, I do not say it with that inkisar, with that kind of sadness, with the grief. How's your health? I just had an open heart surgery, but Alhamdulillah. Amir, Alhamdulillah, no matter what, Alhamdulillah. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took something from me, still many other things with me. If it is not an open heart surgery, Amir, you're still seeing, right? You're still hearing, right? You're still touching, right? Still walking, right? Still talking, right? You use your brain, right? It is just, you know, an open heart surgery and I'm done with it, Alhamdulillah. Remember this, Ya Allah. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. This is how you celebrate that Quran coming to us. It would make sense to you. Related to this one, in Surah At-Tur, in the second rak'ah of the second two rak'ah, when it came to that ayah, wallahi, ayah 48 and 49, I said, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. The ayah is addressing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after suffering, torturing, killing Muslim, his companion, persecuting them, kicking them out of Mecca to live in the valley, eat the branches of the old trees along with their children and so on. Wanted to get rid of him himself. His wife Khadija passed away. His uncle Abu Talib passed away. What is left for you, Ya Rasulullah? Wallahi, nothing. Nothing on the face of earth. Nothing. Literally, nothing. Money, nothing. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Except Quran, except Allah, except the few Sahaba around him. You know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them? وَاصْبِرْ لُحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ. Ya Allah. Ya Allah. Be patient to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained upon you. The ayah would stop at that point and that's it. Wasbir. Wasbir luhukmi rabbika. But what is the rest of the ayah? What is the rest of the ayah saying? Listen to it, wallahi. فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. Ya Allah. Allah is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be patient. No matter what happened to you, you are in the depth of our eyes. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? فَاصْبِرْ لُحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. This is the beauty of the Quran. This is إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. This is the gift you do have. Have some understanding of it and you will love it. And by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not only addressing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاصْبُرْ لُحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ إِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا, is for each and every single one of you. When you are tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you are in a difficult time, when you're suffering, when you're missing something, when you're sick, when you have some disease, when you have this and this and that, anything, فَاصْبِرْ لُحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ. And what, ya Allah, you have? فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. This is Allah. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not with us, or on the seventh heaven, or with Al-Arsh al-Rahman, or beside Allah. Can you imagine? And here, subhanAllah, ya Rabbil Alameen, when a mom is telling one of her kids, or some of the kids are telling me, Habibi, yani, I love you so much, wallah, inta fi'niyya litneen. You are in my eyes, my child, my son, my daughter. How we feel when we hear it from our mom or our dad sometimes. Habibi, inta fi'niyya. Don't you say that? No lie. Don't we hear it? Once in a while? You are in the depth of my eyes. And this is mom and dad telling a son or a daughter. Or a very, very, you know, close one. But how about if you hear it from Allah? Asbir لحكم ربك إنك بأعيننا. يعني you're there like you're the pupil of your eye. Absolute protection. Absolute security. No one can reach you. No one can harm you. No one can cause any bad thing to you. إنك بأعيننا. يعني if you are in the bottom of the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where else you would be or who else could harm you? Answer me, wallahi. This is the beauty of that gift. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. This is how we celebrate this Quran. The meaning of it. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. So I hope that we have learned something today from that gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. And live with this. Any situation, negative, bad, test where you are, إِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. As long as you're patient. As long as sabur, sabur. As long as you're patient, the place you be there safe and secure in the depth of the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all the time in any difficult, in any hardship, in anything we're facing, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen, to give us and grant us that sabr, being patient, and also to be protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is he in his own eyes, inshaAllah. That's when we read, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Now we know the beauty of that gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. When inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen, finishing our prayer tahajjud, Qiyamul Layl, when you reach or when you reach that Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, remember to be thankful and grateful to Allah no matter what. Remember, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, Amir. It's bothering you. I'm bothering me. But Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. What can I do? Jazakumullah khair. Let's inshaAllah continue. InshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. Our Qiyamul Layl, inshaAllah. And we'll have a beautiful dua, inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen, for you. InshaAllah. Jazakumullah khair. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.